Hi guys, my name is Arun Manyar and today we will be discussing about mandibular major connectors. So in one of my last videos, we discussed about maxillary major connectors. So having a quick recap, what is a major connector? So it is that part of an RPD which connects the components of one side of the arch to the components on the other side of the arch. So about the mandibular major connectors, we have five types of mandibular major connectors. First one is the lingual bar, second is the lingual plate, third is the sublingual bar, fourth is the double lingual bar, and fifth is the labial bar. So moving on to lingual bar. So lingual bar, as I have written here, it is half pure in shape. So when you have a cross section at the lingual bar, it is half pure. So if this is a pear, a fruit, if you section it into two parts, so this is kind of our cross section of our lingual bar. Okay, so as we used the last video, advantages I'll be discussing in this block, disadvantages, indications and contraindications. Okay, so I'll use this pattern for all the other four. So what are the advantages of lingual bar? First, it is very easy to fabricate because it is just a bar, and secondly, it has got less tissue coverage. So easy fabrication and less tissue coverage. Okay, going on to its disadvantages. So it is a bar. A bar is very discomforting to the patient. So it interferes with the tongue and it is discomfort. Okay, it is not so user friendly. Next, going on to the indications. So in what cases will we provide our lingual bar? So in the cases where the lingual sulcus is minimum of 8th depth, so from the crest of the gingiva to the depth of the sulcus, so the floor of the mouth, there should be minimum of 8 mm space. So cases where the lingual sulcus has 8 mm space will provide the lingual bar. So why do we need this 8 mm space? So first we break this 8 mm into 3 mm and 5 mm. So 5 mm is the width or the shape of the major connector. This is that is the labial bar. So 5 mm we need for the connector, and 3 mm we need space between the crest of the marginal gingiva to the superior border of the major connector. So this is the space in between. Okay, so 5 mm for the connector itself and 3 mm space between the connector and the crest of the margin. So in which cases are the lingual bar contraindicated? So in cases where there is no space or there is no 8 mm space, so when there is no space, we won't provide with the lingual bar. Okay, moving on further to the lingual plate. So lingual plate is pure in cross section. Here it was half pear in cross section. This is a pear in cross section. So as you can see, this is the inferior border and the superior border is extended upwards and it rests on the cingulum of the anterior tube. So here the advantages are, it is easy to fabricate, again it provides us with indirect retention, it provides us with support and stability as well. The disadvantages of this type of major connector is decalcification of the enamel, because the vise that lies on the superior border, this rests on the cingulum or the lingual surface of the anterior teeth. So when any major connector lies on the teeth directly, it provides us with decalcified tooth structure. Okay, and secondly, it also hampers food impaction. So food impaction occurs. Okay, so now we'll move on to the indications. So what are the indications of lingual plate? So we can give lingual plate in all possible situations. So we'll just write all. And what are the contraindications? So wherever you can provide the patient with lingual bar, we avoid lingual plates. So we'll say in patients where we can give lingual bar, we won't give lingual plate. Okay. Moving on further to the sublingual bar. So here the lingual bar was half pear in cross section. The lingual plate was pear in cross section. And this is kidney shaped. Okay, so in cross section when you see, it is kidney shaped. So what are the advantages? So a sublingual bar is placed very much deep into the sulcus. So So it reduces the obstruction of the patient, obstruction from the tongue or the other soft tissues, and it has a good rigidity. Okay, so these are the advantages. Moving on to the disadvantages. As we place this sublingual bar deep into the sulcus, the extension of that bar or the extension of that major connector is very critical. So for making the impression or placing the major connector, it is very difficult for the dentist to make that. So extension is critical. So in what cases will we give sublingual bar? Indications. Moving on to the indications. So here we can copy this because we have to go deep into the sulcus. So we need more space to place this. So wherever there is more space, so increased space of the lingual sulcus, only then we can indicate or provide with sublingual bar. And in cases where there is no space or the sulcus is shallow, there is not a deep sulcus, so no space, no sublingual bar. Okay, moving on further to the double lingual bar. So as we say, double lingual bar is also known as Kennedy's bar or continuous bar. So it has got a superior border and inferior border. Both are connected with a lateral border, and the superior border has got extensions the same as that in the lingual plate. So the double lingual bar, the advantages of double lingual bar are it helps in indirect retention and it is stable against the horizontal forces. As we saw here, the indirect retention, stability and support, this is stable against horizontal forces. Okay, next we have the disadvantages. So here it is a very complex design, the most complex of all. So because of the complex design, there is food impaction and it is difficult to fabricate. Okay, the indications, in which cases will we provide with the double lingual bar? Okay, so we just learned it through the mnemonic CPD. That is the cases with crowding, the cases with periodontal diseases or a periodontal condition, and the cases of diastema. So these are all non-ideal conditions. So the indications of double lingual bar is all the non-ideal conditions. So on the contrary, the contraindications will be ideal situations. So in ideal conditions, we'll never give a double lingual bar. Okay. Next, moving on to the labial bar. So labial bar, as we saw, it is placed on the labial surface, not on the lingual side of the anterior teeth. So the advantages are, it provides us with the labial support, because as it is placed on the labial surface or the labial surface of a tooth, it provides with the labial support. On the contrary, the disadvantages are, the lip support is distorted. So there is lip support is gone or distorted, and secondly, it interferes with the movement of the soft tissues or movement of the lips. So it is very discomforting to the patients. Okay, moving on to the indications. So if you think about the indication, why there is a need to place a major connector on the labial side, because whenever the anterior teeth are lingually inclined, okay, so lingual inclination of anterior teeth, if the teeth are lingually inclined, you cannot place a major connector lingually because they will act as an interference. Secondly, when lingually there is a undercut present, so it will be difficult in those cases, as well as presence of tori. Okay, so these are the indications, and the contraindications are where it is mostly the last choice of any major connector. So labial bars are not one of the favorite major connectors a dentist would like to give. So it is the last choice of any major connector. So this is mostly not provided in cases except this. Okay, so wrapping up the whole thing, today we saw about the mandibular major connectors. So as we said, we defined the major connectors, then we saw the five types, that is lingual bar, lingual plate, sublingual bar, double lingual bar and labial bar. The lingual bar is half pair in cross section. Lingual plate is pear shaped. The sublingual bar is kidney shaped. The double lingual bar is Kennedy shaped. And then we have the labial bar. So if you see here, the indications and contraindications of the labial, the lingual bar is kind of similar to the sublingual bar. And the advantages of the lingual plate is similar to that of the advantages of double lingual bar. So thank you for watching.